This walk takes you through two very different parts of Oxford City. The first part is along the tranquil towpath beside the canal. Later, a wander through bustling Jericho with its differing styles of architecture. If the length of this walk presents you with mobility difficulties, the best place to visit is Oxford City Shop Mobility. This is the canal path start at Hythe Bridge Street. Most of the path is wide enough for two scooters to be companionably ridden next to one another. With so much to enjoy, this is of great benefit. The Castle Mill Stream is a tributary of the River Thames. It joins the Thames at Oxford. A good smooth surface makes it easy for you to enjoy the views on either side of the canal. Behind the houses on the left is the main train line. It may be possible to hear the trains from time to time as they whiz through Oxford on their way to Paddington. An interesting piece of history. Plenty of comfortable seats ready for you to either rest or bask in the peacefulness beside the canal after the crowds in the city. Coming into view are the barges. Originally, these were working barges where families lived on them, going up and down between Oxford and Coventry. Nowadays, these boats are not working boats, but are used either for pleasure or for a home. You will see signs of which boat is a year-round place to live. Obviously a yearly resident. Saint Frideswide is the patron saint of Oxford. Nowadays, these boats are not working boats, but are used either for pleasure or for a home. You will see signs of which boat is a year-round place to live. We're about to cross the canal. The bridge is quite steep, but absolutely suitable for scooters and wheelchairs. And over we go. It is possible to go in the direction of the cyclist to reach the station, but our walk takes us on. And down the other side. Reaching the west side of Jericho. We will visit this church later in our walk. This is a weir between the canal and the Castle Mill stream. This derelict boatyard was recently lived in by a homeless man who had taken on the task of protecting it from vandals. Unfortunately, the council has turned him out. Local residents are very annoyed as he had become part of the community and was well liked. We stop for a chat with this friendly couple, who have sold their conventional house and now travel about all year round on this barge. They think it is a marvellous way of life, but agree that old age may finally make them live on land. However, until that time, they are going to enjoy the freedom that the barge life offers. Is this dinner? This bridge is only for pedestrians and not accessible to scooters or wheelchairs. Note the barge. All those dark blue barges are named after Oxford colleges. The flats on the right were built on the Eagle Ironworks site. It was a very controversial decision to pull the works down to make way for this development. Behind the flats is the St. Sepulchre's Cemetery, which can be reached from Walton Well Road. Both in World War I and in World War II, the Lucy Works produced munitions, such as this grenade. We are now approaching the busy area of Jericho. Gone is the peaceful atmosphere, and once more we are in the hustle and bustle of a city. However, Jericho is very interesting, and has been made famous by the very popular Inspector Morse films. Quite a steep bridge, but accessible as you can see.
The Lucy Gardens and Flats.
The entrance to the flats, which is on Walton Well Road. You'll be passing this in our walk.
We're at the top, the highest level in the walk. Longworth Road. The Walton Well. There could be trouble ahead. North Oxford style. The Eagle Works Flats Gate.
And so we turn away towards Walton Street. A busy shopping street with individual shops rather than chain stores. Window shopping is a must. Plenty of eating places along this street, and a comfort stop if you need it. The fountain from which Walton Well Road got its name.
The Brasserie Blanc. Daisies. The Jericho Cafe. A sculpture in the Branca. The Harcourt Arms, Cranham Terrace. A well-kept cottage garden. Friends of the Pre-Raphaelite movement. The entrance is steep. Be careful not to fall over backwards. Pride. The the entrance to the Oxford University Press Quadrangle. Somerville College. Ruskin College, founded 1899. The old Redcliffe Infirmary site. We cannot use the pavement at Jericho Street. Inside the Castle Mill boatyard and behind the fence, we see the dock, all in the floodplain. The Castle Mill boatyard site. St. Barnabas Street. A view up Great Clarendon Street, showing the building cranes over the Radcliffe Infirmary site. The Canal Street dropped kerbs. Canal Street, Nelson Street, and Wellington Street Junction. Canal Street. Nelson Street. Magic mushrooms. A painted house. A vintage Morris 1000. Looking up Nelson Street. No dropped kerbs here. We've had to take to the road again. Style in Nelson Street. Oxford Synagogue. Richmond Road. It's spring in Richmond Road. Walton Lane. Bins can cause a problem in some streets with narrow pavements. It's all a facade. Wellington Square. We are forced onto the road in Wellington Square because of poor pavements. But luckily, it is a cul-de-sac. Beaumont Place. This building is elegant and thin. Beaumont Buildings. The Sackler Library. The bus station has all facilities. The walk is circular and can be started at any convenient point.